I just love the zoo, Dad. I can't remember the last time you brought me here.
Jolene, your mom and I are letting you go.
What?
Yeah, it's not working out.
But I'm 9.
I know. It's better to cut the cord now before we get too deep into this thing.
Why are you doing this?
Well, I mean, let's face it, you're not living up to expectations. And you're already drinking and fooling around with boys?
Bobby Jenkins kissed me.
Whatever. Look, the writing's on the wall. By the time you're a teenager, you're gonna be hell on earth.
But I can change.
That's what people always say. They never do. Look, you're young. You'll get over this. You'll find someone else. You need to move on with your life. That's what your mother and I are doing.
You are?
Yeah, she's already pregnant.
She is?
Mm-hmm. This time, we're not taking any chances. She's on a very rigorous health program. She's drinking fresh juices, taking plenty of fresh air walks. You know, when she was pregnant with you, she was really stressed out. In fact, she was smoking quite a bit, so it's not really your fault. It's nothing personal. It's just timing was bad.
So what am I supposed to do?
I mean, that's not really my concern now, is it? You tried it, didn't work out. And hell, you're almost a grown woman. You'll figure it out.
Figure it out? I'm a third grader, and you're leaving me alone in the middle of New York City? At the zoo, and it's none of your concern? I don't even have any money.
Hey, don't make this about money, all right? I took good care of you for 9 long years. You had your own maid, you went to a private school, and you were a spoiled, rotten only child, and you screwed it up. You know, that's the problem with people these days. They just don't want to take any responsibility. I'm actually doing you a favor by abandoning you.
Can I call you at least?
It's probably best if you don't, with your mom and I pregnant and all.
No, you want to do it right this time.
Thanks for understanding.
It's the responsible thing to do.
That's my girl. Ex. Girl.
I guess this is goodbye.
Yeah.
Do you think I can get a hug, Dad?
It's Mr. Wilson.
Mr. Wilson, do you think I could get a hug?
I know this is gonna sound harsh, but...
Oh, come on!
Look, you gotta trust me on this one. It's more for you than me. I've been down this road before.
You have?
You had a brother.
I did?
Yeah, and he was 4, and anyway, it wasn't working. Look, it doesn't matter. But things change, people change. It's better to get out of a bad relationship than to live a lie. You know what I'm saying?
No.
Well, see, that's where we're different. Look. I'm not into messy goodbyes, all right? I'm just gonna give you an air hug and be on my way, all right? So... All right, now, Mrs. Wilson wants me to pick up some Chinese and I don't wanna keep her waiting, so... I know I shouldn't do this. It's not like I'm giving you any money, though. If I just happen to drop a 10 on the ground and you pick it up, well then...
Hey.
All right. Now, good luck out there, and thanks for the memories. Just remember, when one door closes, another one invariably opens. Okay?
I guess so.
That's a spirit. Oh, hi.
Hi. Are you almost home?
I'm leaving right now.
Ooh, it took a long time.
Well, I had to explain a few things.
Was she upset?
I actually thought she took it quite well.
Ooh, well, that's great. You know, it is for the best.
Yeah. So, you want the Kung Pao chicken, right?
Yeah. Oh, and sweetie, don't forget the fortune cookies.
Okay.